You know, you're really single and ready to mingle like a Pringle and just waiting for somebody to make this thing tangle. What's up, everyone? It's your girl, the kind of S-I-M-O-N-E, and I am back. With another video. So, it's been like 2 weeks since I've been on your screen, right? And as you can tell by the title of this video, I'm giving you guys a story time of one of the worst, weirdest dates I had. Before we even get into that, I got some good news to share with y'all. So as you guys know, your girl been recording on my phone this whole time, right? And my phone is in my hands, so that means your girl got a camera, baby. I'm so excited, I'm so happy. Like, I'm literally looking at the viewfinder over here and like I see me and I'm looking at the camera like, yo, this is an actual camera. Like, the camera vibes, like the whole camera setup vibes, you know, there's a girl. Okay, I'm looking over here. I'm sorry, I can see me, and I look bright, I look nice, I look cool. All right, story time. So, as you guys know, I moved from New York to Connecticut to DC in the span of like 4 months. When I moved to DC was because of the like breakup that I had in New York, but that's here nor there. But this does come with the story. Your girl was getting over a breakup, and your girl thought she wanted to be big and bad and bold and crazy, and decided it's time to start dating. It's time to start meeting these ladies. It's time to start, you know, doing what we gotta do, because you know you're really single and ready to mingle like a Pringle and just waiting for somebody to make this thing tangle. I'm like, all right, I'm on Tinder, I'm on Bumble, I'm on all them little apps, whatever, to meet the girls. And I'm like, I'm ready to do this. Meet this one girl. Not gonna drop no names, so we just gonna call her like Teresa or something, right? So I meet Teresa. And I think we end up going to like some seafood place or whatever, right? If I tell you more of these stories, I'm gonna tell you a lot of them end up at seafood places because your girl loves seafood and, the girls do too. So, end up at a seafood place. Not one of those main ones, like one of those mom and pop shop seafood places, right? And we're there, you know, eating, drinking, having like a decent time or whatever, just talking about life, talking about what we wanna do, like where we're trying to go in life, goals, dreams, aspirations, and stuff like that. I'm like, oh great, this is going well. Here's the thing. In the middle of this date, I'm like, why am I doing this? This is not for me. I'm not ready for this, but I'm here and I'm not just gonna get out and walk away, right? Because in that moment, I really realized I wasn't ready. This had to be like maybe month 3-4 of me living here and probably month 5 after the breakup. So I'm like, I'm not really ready, but I'm trying, you know, because they say the best way to get over somebody is stick it under somebody else. So I'm trying to test the theory, right? Wrong. After the whole little date and witch and bitch, we are messed up. Well, I am. And I think she was too, but like, I don't know people. So she has messed up as she can be. But I, you know, I like to drink, you know. And, we get out, we get back to my apartment, and not even my apartment, like outside in front. So my apartment has like two entrances and exits. So there's one in the middle of the building and one on the side of the building. So we're at the one in the middle of the building, but off to the side because like, you know, people come in out the door. So, I said about the car, and I'm like, all right, thanks, you know, I'm gonna let you know, whatever, thanks for the time, thanks for the meal, thanks for dinner, thanks for hanging out, whatever. At this point, I'm like, yo, like, kind of probably just want to be friends with this person, but also, like, kind of feeling it because the drinks in the system, I don't know. But then in the back of my mind, I'm like, you don't really want this, you just drunk, so no. So, girl gets out the car and I'm like, okay, like if something gets to, you know, happen, starting, popping, like, I don't mind. I wouldn't mind. Gets out the car, we go to the side of the building, not the this side, the other side of the building. And we start making out, right? And this girl is like, you know, touching all of a kid, and I'm touching all of a girl, whatever. And I'm like, this is great. This is cool. Like, maybe I am ready for this. You know, maybe I do want to do this. You know, I'm like, all right, well, let's possibly like bring her up to the house or whatever the case. And I'm like, no. Like, stop, skirt, cut. You're not ready for this. Mind you, I'm having this whole entire conversation in my head while we're making out. So I'm like, okay, what do you do? What do you do? Like, do you want to do this with this girl? Do you not want to do this with this girl? Like, you need to make a decision now before it gets too far. In the middle of us like making out, I kind of was like, you know what? Not ready for this. Like, I don't want this to go any further. Thanks for the night. So she's like, okay, cool, like totally respect it. And that's great, because like with women, like we really respect boundaries and stuff. Not to say men don't respect boundaries, but like women respect boundaries, you know? So she respected that. That was cool. We don't talk anymore, so there's that. But here's where the story gets a little weird. And here's why I knew I was upstairs in my house, door. And immediately start just like spitting. When I mean like trying to get her saliva out of my mouth, mind you, I already know it's already in the esophagus, in my chest, already went down. I know this. But I was like not disgusted by her, not at all. But I think I was just totally not ready and not in the mood for nothing. So I'm here like trying to spit out every inch of saliva I can. I get my toothbrush, toothpaste, brushing my teeth. I get mouthwash, like trying to rinse my mouth out. And I knew at that point, I was like, nah, I'm not ready. I'm not ready for this. I'm not ready for this dating lifestyle. I'm not ready to do anything with anybody. I am clearly not over this breakup, even though it's been like 4 months. And I told you, I like cried because I was so upset that I was still not over that breakup. And I'm like, why can't I be over this breakup? At that moment, at that point, your girl is not doing well. So that was last year. We good now. We popping, we better now. But yeah, that's one of my horrible. So that's all I have for you guys today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys enjoyed the story time. I know it's a little weird, a little different, a little out there, but I want to know if this happened to anybody. Or is it just me? Because I know that was a little weird. You know, in the comment section down below, subscribe to my channel, turn on those post notifications, follow me on all my social medias at The Kind of Simone. It's on the bar on the screen right here. So follow your girl and let's be friends, let's connect. I will see you guys in the next video. Don't forget, Pride Month is coming up next month. And you know a lot of bangers coming through, baby. See you in the next one. Bye. Blue face, baby. Come on, if I see you, bust on. Ah! Yes. Follow.